Very good afternoon to you. Welcome to a brand new week of Countdown. You know, 25 years ago today, Lionel Richie went to number one in the charts with Hello. Remember him, I'm sure. Chris Kamara's identical twin brother. Waiting by the board. She's once, twice, three times a lady. Rachel Riley. Hi, Rachel.
Afternoon, Joe.
Been doing a bit of research, Rachel.
All right.
You can remember it all? What was number one in the charts when you were born?
I can't remember, no. I don't know. 80s, probably Madonna or Bon Jovi or someone.
It was the Pet Shop Boys with West End Girls. It should have been Essex Girls, really, shouldn't it? but in America, it was a song called Say You, Say Me, again, by Lionel Richie. You see, you are inextricably linked with Lionel Richie.
Sure. Never heard that one before.
Obviously not a big fan, are you? I can tell that.
Not the biggest.
I think when I was born, number one was the 1812 Overture, something like that. Let's meet our contestants today, shall we? Julie Russell, she's our defending champion. She's a dental receptionist from Dumfries, where she lives with her partner, Greg. She has two daughters, Debbie and Rachel, and a two-month-old granddaughter, Amy. And Julie says the person she'd most like to meet is Billy Connolly. Makes you laugh then, does he, Julie?
Absolutely, yes. Yeah.
Lovely to see you again, Julie. Up against Julie today is Dominic Colley. Dominic is a primary school teacher from Darlington, where he lives with his wife, Jennifer, and daughter, Anna. His hobbies include golf, football and rugby. He also enjoys running. He's completed four Great North runs. He says his ambitions are to see England win the World Cup and for his daughter to sleep through the night. Now, which do you think will happen first, Dominic?
Probably my daughter sleep through the night.
Probably. He says his favourite place is Craster. Craster?
It's on Northumberland coast, yeah.
Oh, famous for kippers.
That's right, yeah. Best in the world.
Best. OK. Our contestants today, the defending champion, Julie Russell and Dominic Colley. Our guest in Dictionary Corner this week, a man who's been on the show more often than Rachel and I put together. Please welcome back Giles Brandreth.
Good to be here. It's exciting to be here. I'm thrilled to be here, Jeff. Can I tell you, 25 years ago today, on the 27th of April, 1984, I was here wearing a ludicrous jumper with a stupid teddy bear on the front, and I had a bear behind as well. I mean, I looked ridiculous. But today, in your honour, Jeff, I've come with the new butch look. I'm here all man to compensate for you being here as well.
And, of course, alongside Giles. Well, it's, you know, like having a double act back together, isn't it? You know, like pie and chips or bacon and eggs. Of course, it's Brandreth and Dent. Susie Dent. We've got a very young audience in today, actually, Susie, haven't we? And it's interesting to think that in years to come, they'll be responsible for some of the words which you and I might not understand now, but will be in the dictionary in future generations.
It's the brilliant thing about slang. I love it because you can never quite catch it. It just moves so fast. You're always running after it. But yeah, you're right. They'll be leading the way.
Leading the way today is Julie, our defending champion. It's our first letters round. And Julie, it's your pick of those letters.
Hello, Rachel.
Hi, Julie.
Can I have a consonant, please?
You can. We'll start with G.
And another.
Z.
And another.
P.
Another consonant, please.
R.
A vowel.
E.
Another.
A.
And another vowel.
O.
A consonant.
V.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final S.
And for the first time this week, let's start the countdown clock. Dominic.
I've got a six.
A six. Julie?
Six.
Okay, what's yours, Julie?
Proves.
And Dominic?
Grapes.
Yeah, a couple of six-pointers. What have you got over there, folks?
I saw on the list what looked like the name of a former Polish Prime Minister, but other than that, no, we can't do better than six, I'm afraid.
Thanks very much indeed. Julie and Dominic both on the scoreboard in the first round, then 6 points apiece. Here's our next letters round. Dominic, your pick this time.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Dominic.
Can I have a consonant, please?
You can. We'll start with D.
And another.
N.
And another consonant.
C.
And can I have a vowel?
E.
And another vowel.
I.
And another.
Another E.
And a consonant, please.
S.
And another consonant.
T.
And a final vowel, please.
And a final A.
And your 30 seconds starts now. So, Julie, how many this time?
Safe seven.
Safe seven. Dominic?
And a seven.
OK, what's yours, Dominic?
Stained.
And the safe seven, Julie, yeah?
Same stained thing. As well.
Yeah. Were you thinking about dabbling with a risky eight, Julie?
Possibly candiest.
Candiest?
I well, wondered about that. I don't think candiest.
I don't think it's going to count, is it? Candies are allowed, of course.
Yes.
And but the sweetest person in the room is not necessarily the candiest. Not at least as
not
far as the Oxford Dictionary is concerned.
No.
Candiest isn't there, but
it's
we
there,
think there might be an eight-letter word, don't we?
There is, yeah. Put it on the pen cam here. It's andesite, A-N-D-E-S-I-T-E. In geology, it's a dark, fine-grained, brown or greyish volcanic rock.
As it is today, it was a very good decision to stick with the safe seven. It means that Julie has 13 and Dominic has 13. Here's our next round. Julie, your pick, please.
A consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Julie. C.
A vowel.
O.
Consonant.
F.
Vowel.
I.
A consonant.
J.
Another consonant.
R.
A vowel.
U.
Another vowel.
O.
And a consonant, please.
And to finish, S.
And time starts now. Not easy. Dominic?
A five.
Julie?
A risky five.
OK, what's your risky five?
Fours.
Mm-hmm. As in more than one, yeah. And yours, Dominic?
Roofs.
Few fives around. Anything better than five?
Fours is fine, isn't it, for five? Is roofs OK? It's not roofs
yes.
With a V. It can be both, probably.
It can be both. I remember looking at this up a long time ago. No, it can absolutely be both. There's no problem with that at all.
For a moment, I was stuck on a two-letter word myself. Joe, being a Scottish sweetheart, a word I think originated by the poet Robert Burns. But here we are celebrating this week the 445th birthday of William Shakespeare. Mm-hmm. And he led me to another name, not Joe, but Curio, a character from Twelfth Night, the play. And then I thought maybe we could have curios, both as a version, an early English version of the word curious, but also as a curio that you collect something that's a bit odd, is a curio. Could you have curio in the plural?
You
curios?
Can. Intriguing objects are curios.
So we'd have scored 6 points.
We would. Well
yes.
Done.
Still neck and neck. Julie and Dominic inseparable, 18 points apiece. Here's our next letters round. Dominic, your pick.
Can I have a consonant, please?
Thank you. Start with R.
And another.
L.
And a third.
R.
And a vowel, please.
A.
And another.
U.
And another.
E.
And a consonant, please.
M.
And another.
T.
And a final vowel, please.
And a final A.
And here's the countdown clock. Julie, how many this time?
Six.
And Dominic?
And a six as well.
OK. What's yours, Dominic?
Unreal.
And Julie?
Amulet.
Yes, I love that sort of lucky talisman, lucky charm. There's no N, though, Dominic, for unreal, I'm afraid.
Well, unreal. It was unreal. It was genuinely unreal. Doesn't he get a bonus for that?
Mm. No.
Can you not be a bit flexible?
Living the word.
It was unreal, and he doesn't get a point. There is no justice. He's an amateur. Amateur is there for seven letters.
Very good.
You're making us look like amateurs. That's the problem at the moment, Giles.
It's exciting. It's very exciting. It's because I'm on drugs. That is a joke, I assure you. Rest assured. But a little bit of caffeine at lunch goes a long way.
Julie has just edged ahead. She has 24 and Dominic has 18. Time for our first numbers round. And, Julie, your selection, please.
Can I have one from the top, please, Rachel, and any other five?
Thank you. Of course, you can. One from the top and five small. So, for this first numbers game of the week, we've got 6, 1, 5, 2, and the large one, 25. And the target, 610.
And 30 seconds to reach that target. Dominic?
610.
Mm-hmm. Julie?
610.
Dominic, let's have your version.
3 + 1.
3 + 1 = 4.
4 × 6 = 24.
× 6 = 24.
24 × 25 = 600. And then 2 × 5 to make the 10.
2 × 5 = 10. And add it all, 610. Very nice.
Julie, same method?
The same way, yes.
Yeah. Well done. Good contest to start the week. Julie on 34, Dominic 28. They're just going to take a little breather because we're going to pop over to Dictionary Corner. Well, Giles...
Well, I'm sitting here and I'm during the break. I'm going to be twittering a few of my friends. Do you do this Twitter thing?
I don't. I have
if you don't know what Twitter is, it's a kind of sort of text messaging thing and you actually send out messages. The advantage is you can only use 140 sort of spaces to send your message. And I've become hooked on this since I was last here. When I was a boy, I used to be hooked on telegrams. And I twittered some of my friends to say, I'm on countdown today, great telegrams from the past. And some people have sent in. Obviously, there was a famous telegram, which all of you will know, the one that was sent to by a reporter to the film star Cary Grant with the inquiry, how old Cary Grant? The reporter was writing an article about Cary Grant. The message was, how old Cary Grant? The reply from Cary Grant came back, old Cary Grant, fine, how you? It was an impertinent question. But here's an historic one. My friend Dave Gorman sent me this. The genuine telegram sent to report the relief of Mafeking. It was sent from Mafeking to London, and the message simply read, all well, 4 hours bombardment, one dog killed. That's history in a telegram. Rudyard Kipling, the great writer, yes, wrote exceedingly good poetry, and he was paid about 10 shillings a word, 50p in the new money, and students sent him 50p, 10 shillings, and asked for a word from him, and he sent them a telegram that simply said, thanks. I was once in America where they had singing telegrams, and I was at a birthday party in California, and it was the lady's 40th birthday, and the telegram boy arrived wearing a little pillbox hat, and he was holding the telegram, and the woman said, sing me the telegram, because they had singing telegrams in the States, and she said, sing me the telegram. He said, I don't want to sing the telegram. She said, sing me the telegram, it's my birthday. And the poor boy stepped forward, opened the telegram and sang. Tra-la-la-la-la-la, your sister Rose is dead.
Here's your first teaser today. The words are leg shins, leg shins. And the clue, they sound unmarried and are very sore. They sound unmarried and are very sore. They sound unmarried and are very sore shingles. The answer to our teaser. Julie has 34. Dominic has 28. Let's move on to our next letters round. Dominic, your choice.
Hi, can I get a consonant, please?
Thank you, Dominic. We'll start with Q.
And another one, please.
D.
And a third.
R.
And a vowel.
E.
And another.
A.
And another.
O.
And a consonant, please.
S.
And another consonant.
T.
And a final vowel.
And to finish, A.
And here's the countdown clock. Julie, how many?
Seven.
And Dominic?
And just six.
OK, what's the six, Dominic?
Stored.
And Julie, the seven?
Roasted.
Anything better than seven over there?
We can't do better than seven, but we're going to give you an anagram of roasted. I think it's an Elizabethan word. It comes from the Italian. A form of clothing, if one wore an elegant garb. A twisted piece of cloth or linen or silk.
You could wear them in your hair as well.
A torsade.
A braid.
A braid.
Torsade. Great word. Well done, Julie. 41 points. Dominic has 28. Very early stages, of course, of the contest at the moment. Julie, your pick of the letters.
A consonant, please.
Thank you. K.
And another.
N.
And another.
L.
A vowel.
E.
And another.
A.
And another vowel, please.
I.
A consonant.
R.
Another consonant.
N.
And a last consonant, please.
And the last one, T.
30 seconds starts now. Dominic?
Six.
Six. Julie?
Seven.
OK, what's the six, Dominic?
Tinker.
And the seven, Julie?
Reliant.
What have you got over there, folks?
It's much easier for us, because we're not against the clock in the same way. I thought of it after the time was up, but here is internal.
Brilliant, well done.
Internal.
Very good indeed. I looked at it, could just come up with a little tinkle. Nothing more than that.
Yes, you can't have a tinkler, sadly. I looked that one up.
A tinkler?
You can't be a tinkler.
On to our next round. Judy, 48. Dominic, 28. Dominic, your choice.
Hi, can I have a consonant, please?
Thank you very much. You can have a S.
And another?
M.
And another consonant?
G.
And a vowel, please.
E.
And another vowel?
O.
And a third, please.
I.
And a consonant.
B.
And another consonant.
L.
And a final vowel, please.
And a final E.
And your time starts now. Julie, what have you got?
Five.
And Dominic?
And a five.
OK, what's yours, Dominic?
Miles.
And Julie?
Boyles.
Anything better than five over in the corner?
Well, we think we have got better than five. A five-letter word that is there is blogs. You know, earlier I was talking about Twitter, and it's interesting how, as it were, the 21st century is building already its own vocabulary. Both those words, blogs and Twitter, were not in the dictionary when Countdown began. They're there today. Interestingly, the word snog has been in the dictionary, certainly in my vocabulary, for quite a while. And since snog is there, I wondered if snoggable would be allowed. If it is, you know, if I said to you, you were snoggable, that would be an eight-letter word, would it be legitimate? Obviously, I wouldn't say that to you.
Would I be snoggable? No, it's not in.
It wouldn't be legitimate because there's no N.
Oh.
Good point.
It's an M, is it?
It's an M.
Oh, that's why I've got complete... Oh! Smoggable, that's what it...
Smoggable, that's
it. Oh, if there's an M, then I've got a seven-letter word. If there's an M, mobiles.
The seven weapon.
Great recovery. on to our next round. It's another letters round. Julie, your choice.
A consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Julie. R.
And another.
D.
And a third, please.
H.
A vowel.
A.
And another.
O.
And another.
E.
A consonant, please.
T.
Another consonant.
Another T.
And a vowel, please.
And the last one, U.
And your 30 seconds starts now. Dominic?
A six.
Julie?
A risky eight.
OK, let's have the six first, Dominic.
Hotter.
What's the risky eight then, Julie?
Throated.
A full-throated performance. But is it only full-throated? Can it be throated on its own? I think probably it's one of those words with a combination only. So frustrating! Because the word I had, the seven-letter word, isn't there either. I had truthed. If you speak a truth, have you truthed? I've truthed today.
Do you know, I'm going to allow throated.
What?
It's that, you know, we often talk about we can have quarter pounder or that kind of thing, and pounder there is a combination word, and we allow that, so I'm going to allow throated.
Very good. Here's a novel word for you. Authored.
That's superb. Well done, you.
What's the word?
Authored.
Authored. That's brilliant.
Julie has 61 and Dominic has 33. They can just take a breather again. Got to pop back to Dictionary Corner. This time we're looking at the origins of some words with Susie. What are we looking at this week, Susie?
I was going to talk about bells and whistles. Where does bells and whistles come from? And it's actually been around in its literal sense for a very long time, because before modern electronics, in railroads, steam engines, that sort of thing, there was only two ways that you could make a noise. You rang a bell or you tooted a whistle. But actually, the real sense today of things which are a little bit sort of, you know, a little bit frippery, with a frippery or something on top, probably comes from that really wonderful invention, the cinema organ. You know, in the heyday of films, and the organ would rise out of the pit with the organist to entertain the audience.
Sandy Powell.
Sandy Powell.
That's for the more mature among our viewers.
And the accompaniment to silent films, obviously, as well. They had the Mighty, remember the Mighty Wurlitzer? I've seen pictures of the Mighty Wurlitzer.
Knew him personally.
And that had lots and lots of wonderful sound effects as well, which were called toys. And they would have these toy counters, and the Mighty Wurlitzer had about 20 different sort of sound effects of whistles, of gunshots, of all sorts of things. And when, of course, films became talking films, and they were no longer needed because the action was on the screen, they still had these little toys to play with, but they were less important to the film. And so they became a little bit kind of extraneous to the action, but wonderful. And they were the bells and whistles.
Can
they
I
were
say,
little bits on top.
That's clear what, really why I'm here. I am the bells and whistles here. Unnecessary and extra, and I can be pulled down and reduced at the end, like the organ. I'm now going down, I'm disappearing below the desk. It's all over.
Thank you very much indeed, Susie and Giles. Let's move on. Julie, 61. Dominic, 33. Long way to go yet. Time for our next numbers round. Dominic, it's your selection.
I can have one from the top and five small ones, please.
One from the top and five small, nice and easy. Let's see what we've got for this round. Start with 10. And two, one, six, another two, and 75, and the target, 800.
30 seconds to reach that target. Julie,
800.
Dominic?
800.
Julie, let's hear your version this time.
6 minus 1.
6 minus 1 is 5.
+75.
+75 is 80.
× 10.
× 10. 800.
Dominic, same way?
I just did 75, add 2, add the 1 to make the 80. Yeah.
Well done. Here's another teaser for you. The words this time are rap disco. Rap disco. And the clue is, the clue to this is somewhat irregular. The clue to this is somewhat irregular.
The Space Shuttle Pursuit launched from Arlington Space Centre this morning.
Get straight to the point with digital text on Channel 4. For the latest information fast, just press text.
The clue to this is somewhat irregular. Sporadic, of course, is the answer. Nothing sporadic about Julie's performance. She has 71. Dominic has 43. Still time for it all to change, though. Here's the next letters round. Julie, your pick.
A consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you. P.
And another.
N.
And another.
G.
A vowel.
O.
And another.
I.
And another.
O.
Another vowel, please.
E.
A consonant.
P.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final R.
And your 30 seconds starts now. Dominic?
Risky 7.
OK, Julie?
6.
OK, what's the 6, Julie?
Roping.
And the risky 7, Dominic?
I'm afraid it's pooping.
Pooping!
Yes.
Pooping was emperor of China in the 14th century.
Yeah.
A great dynasty. Pooping. Is pooping allowed in the...
Yes. And there's another sense to it as well. In America, it's to stop functioning. To poop out is to stop working.
I'm pooping out now. That's very, very good. The word you were thinking of, the rude word, isn't pooping. It's pooing. And pooing is there as well. But that would only have scored you 6. And while we're on those funny words, pongo is there as well. You know, if the pooping goes wrong and the pooing goes wrong, you end up with a pongo. But a pongo is a legitimate word as well. It's in the dictionary. It's a slang term from the Crimean War. It's a kind of soldier, a pongo.
Pooping was quite good enough for Dominic. Keeps him in the game as well. Julie has 71 and Dominic has 50 at the moment. On to our next letters round. Dominic, it's your pick.
I can have a consonant, please.
Thank you. T.
And another.
W.
And another.
N.
And a vowel, please.
I.
And another vowel.
E.
And another vowel, please.
Another I.
And a consonant.
S.
Another consonant.
R.
And a final vowel, please.
And a final E.
30 seconds starts now. Julie?
7.
Dominic?
And a 7.
OK, what's yours, Dominic?
Winters.
Winters, yeah. And Julie?
Winters.
couple of winters, I was intrigued because not often do we get this combination of letters. If you look at the letters on the board, you've got actually three legitimate words in succession. Twine, is, and re, all of them in the dictionary. And I was sort of foxed by that, but I did see some seven-letter words, and you did too. I got Western. What did you find?
Entries was my seven.
So, three different lots of seven-letter words.
Very good. Julie, 78. Dominic, 57 at the moment. Here's the next round. It's a letters round. Julie.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Julie. M.
And another.
S.
And another.
F.
A vowel.
A.
And another.
I.
And another.
Another A.
And another vowel, please.
E.
A consonant.
X.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final B.
Time starts now. Dominic, how many this time?
Just a five.
And Julie?
A risky six.
OK, what's the five, Dominic?
Exams.
And the risky six, Julie?
Mafias.
Mafias.
Well, I don't think that will be allowed. Let me just state my case. Mafia is a group of people, capital M.
Yes, the Mafia has a capital M, but any group that exerts a sinister influence can be used generically or termed generically a mafia, so it's fine.
Oh, as in Raffia Mafia?
As in Raffia Mafia?
Yeah, the people who are gang together and make baskets.
Them too.
I saw a three-letter word there, Bax. Bax is the name of an English composer, Sir Arnold Bax, a great and underrated English composer. It was he who gave us that wonderful and immortal piece of advice: in this life, you should try everything once, except for incest and folk dancing.
Julie has 84. Dominic has 57. Time for our next numbers round. And Dominic, your selection this time.
Can I have two large ones and four small ones, please?
Two large ones and four small. Thank you. For this last numbers game, we've got 3 and 10, 6, 4, and the large ones, 50 and 25. And the target, 176.
30 seconds to reach that target. Julie?
176, not written down.
OK. Dominic?
176.
Let's have the not written down version then, Julie.
3 times 50.
3 times 50 is 150.
Times 3. Oh, sorry. Plus 25.
Plus 25, 175.
10 minus 6 is 4.
10 minus 6 is 4.
Divide by the other
over
4
the
is 1 and add
1.
It on.
And add it all together for 176.
Dominic, same way?
Yeah, same start, and then I did 6 add 4 is 10, and then 10 over 10 for the 1 to add to the 175.
Very good, well done. So with the score, Julie 94, Dominic 67. It's time to put those fingers on the buzzers as we reveal today's countdown conundrum. Julie.
Imploding.
Let's take a look. Very well done. Julie goes through the 100 barrier. She has 104. Dominic has 67. So commiserations to Dominic Collier. It wasn't the case of the Collie wobbles, was it?
Not this time, Jeff.
No. OK. You get your goodie bag, of course. What sort of age group of children do you teach?
Well, I'm actually teaching primary at the moment, so year twos, that's 6, 7-year-olds.
They'll be watching. I'm sure they'll be very proud that you did so well. I hope you've enjoyed it anyway.
Yes, excellent. Thank you.
Julie. Well, this is proving rather less painful than a visit to your dental surgery, isn't it?
Yes.
You're not meant to say that. All your bosses will say it's painless going to the dentist these days. Great. Well, very well done indeed. Two successes in a row. We'll see you again tomorrow. Giles, very much enjoyed your company. And I have to say, you're the first guest who's managed to get pooing, incest and folk dancing into one programme.
That's my style. But life now is so shocking. I went to the dentist the other day. They swing you back in a chair. They come on you. They're all wearing masks. It's like taking part in a terrifying episode of Doctor Who going to the dentist. But it is indeed painless. They jab you with all sorts of things. And in fact, it's probably because I went to the dentist last week, I'm still like this. I may have recovered by tomorrow. I hope so.
Giles and Susie will be back tomorrow, and so too will Rachel. Rachel, I've got a feeling that you're not too well acquainted with Lionel Richie, really, so... Shall we zoom off and listen to my collection? I think
I'm
we should.
Not acquainted.
She will be by tomorrow. It's easy. We'll be back at 3:25. Bye-bye now.